Hi, Omega Chaos here again with another attack profile. This time I'm going to show my Vylan deck. A really interesting deck. The Vylan Archetype has never really played much in the metagame because of the fact that the deck is kinda inconsistent and it relies on certain combo plays which you might not always get. But it's still a really fun deck to play, and if it goes off, then your opponent can't really do much. So let's go to this deck. First, a free Photon Thresher. It's just as a level 4 monster, I can spell someone. To be able to make a synchro plays. Then 2 Triant Warrior. Its effect is that when discard is normal summon, I can press one level 3 monster from my hand. So which will be Rhyon Cube. To be able to synchro summon into levels and synchro and get the Vylan Cube's effect off. And then 3 Genex Neutron. If a normal summon discard, then in end phase I can search out the machine type tuner from the deck. So to search out my Vylan Cube, which is very essential card for this deck. And finally Vylan Hept, which is a pretty good card in here. It is 1800 attack beater, and it's important because it's a non-tuner Vylan monster. Its effect isn't really that relevant because most are not going to equip Vylan monsters to this card, but it's still, I think it's pretty good. Then your Vylan tuner monsters, free Vylan Prism, of course, really good. When it's sent from the monster card to the graveyard, I can pay 500 to equip it to a monster I control, and then this card, that card gains the total attack during the damage step. So yeah, and it's a really good summon out with one element for the loop. So yeah, and then 3 Vylan Cube, the most important tuner in this deck. When this card is sent to give up for a synchro summon of light monster, I can add one equip spell from a deck to my hand. And mostly I'm going to search out the Road of Silence Chaos for the loop. Then other tuners, Vylan Tetra. When this card is sent from Master Cards from the graveyard, I can pay 500 to equip the monster, and then if that monster will destroy, you can destroy this instead. And then 2 Vylan Sphere, it's a level 1 tuner, and as well you can equip to the monster if this card is sent from Master Cards from the graveyard. And then I can, when it's equipped, and just send this card to the graveyard to equip one equip spell from the graveyard to that monster. So yeah, these two are essential to summon out your Vylan Omega when you do the loop. And finally, the last monster is Honest in the main deck. Spells, one Vylan Matter, just to send equip spells back to the deck, and then I can destroy one card or draw one card. So definitely mostly going to search out at the end of the loop. Then 2 Vylan Element, of course the most essential card for the loop. When a face of one equip card you control is destroyed, and you press one Vylan tuner to deck up to the number of equip cards destroyed, and the special ones can only use the synchro materials for a Vylan monster. So yeah, definitely really powerful card in this deck. Just constantly summon your one tuners from the deck with the loop with Road of Sands Chaos. And I only run 2 because it, of course, it's searchful with all at one equip in the center graveyard from the field. Then of course the one equips 2 materia. Their effects aren't really that relevant, they are just there for the loop. This equip the Vylan monster, and then that monster gains 600 attack, and then discard equip the Vylan monster, and then it can be targeted by the effects of trap cards and effect monsters. And of course all the Vylan equip cards are fixed that when they are sent to graveyard on the field face up, you can search out the Vylan spell guard from the deck. And then one filament equipped to the Vylan monster, and then If the queen monster attacks upon contact with these person traps, then on component, which is basically like a fairy metal crush that that monster can inflict piercing damage. Finally, the last equip card is Rod of Sun's Chaos, very important for the loop. Basically, the loop requires the one known to a Vion monster, Vion element, Rod of Sun's Chaos, and any Vion equip card. So yeah, then you can pretty much go up somewhat free Vion prison from the deck if in the yeah in the loop, and as well as two Vion tuners. So you can pretty much enter your field with either 3 Matea rank 4 or 2 Matea rank 4 and the Vion Omega. And if Vion Omega is on the field, of course, your opponent can't really do much. So yeah, definitely the way the loop of course works, that this card pretty much prevents pretty much if a spell got targets at the Weave Master, that spell card is instantly negated and destroyed. So then pretty much the equip card will be destroyed, and then you can search a Vion spell card from the deck and Vion element's effect triggers. Then two reinforcements of the army to search out your Photon Thresher or Giant Warrior, and finally Tarkul. Traps stun just to go off safely, because of course this deck is very weak to back row. You really need to get your combo off. Then Solemn Warning, Black Horn of Heaven, Bottomless Trap Hole, and Two Fang Chain of the Exo deck. Vion Omega, the key synchro card you're going to summon at the end of the loop. It trade costs two tuners and one non-tuner Vion monster. When this card synchro summon, destroy of all face up normal monsters, normal summon monsters on the field. And once per turn, I can target one Vion monster in the graveyard equipped to this card. And when the effect of if the next effect monster is activated, I can spend one equip card equipped to discard to the graveyard, negate activation, and destroy that monster. So yeah, definitely really good. You must have Divine Life on legs, and mostly going to have at least three cards equipped to discard, so you can negate the effect of monsters pretty much three times. Then Leo the Keeper of Sectry, Vion Alpha, pretty good. I summon this when I can't go into Vion Omega. So yeah, it's pretty good, but unfortunately it only has 2200 attack. Then Vion Epsilon, also pretty good. It's basically like a scrap dragon of violence. And just send one equip card to discard to graveyard to add one monster one controls and destroy the turret. So yeah, not bad. Then Star Spark Dragon, not bad. Combos well with Vion Prism, of course. Then your level 7s. Vion Sigma, pretty good. Probably not going to use that effect, his effect much, but just yeah, good. It's got this declared attack and it's only monster. I can equip one equip spell card from the deck to this face of card. And then Vion Delta, which is pretty good. Because if card isn't face of defense in the end phase, I can in my end phase I can search the equip spell card from deck to my hand, so you're not bad. Then finally, Koyo Guardian and Armada's Keeper of Boundaries, the best level 6 synchro and the best level 5 synchro. Then the Xyz Monster, Vion T-Sigma, of course it's a Vion Xyz Monster, of course, and you just summon out the 3 Vion Prisms with the loop and then go into this. So yeah, not bad. And even some Ouroboros as the other 3 Matea rank 4 Xyz Monster, of course really good as well. You want to summon this instead of Vion T-Sigma, then other rank 4s, number 1 on Sato Arc, Gorgon Antiluminous Knight, Apes from Exodus Knight, and finally Gar Cargoyle. So this was my Vion deck profile. It's a pretty interesting deck, but obviously it's not very competitive. But I still suggest to try it out at least. Yeah, then problem with this deck also is that it really only has one play, and if you can't get it off, can't get the right cards to your hand, or your opponent stops you, then the deck pretty much unfortunately falls apart. So yeah. So this is it for this deck profile. I hope you enjoyed it. For now, goodbye and Omakios out.